Press out on Kavanaugh. He cuts. Perkovic wants it, gets it. The drought is over.
Wow.
The Motor City Hitman makes it a two-goal game, and that one had some noise.
Painting corners. 6'4", 220 pounds, and 105 miles an hour. This is what it looks like. One of the most lethal outside shooters in all of college lacrosse. It's not just the brute force when 16 and White has the rock. It's the mechanics, the hip rotation.
Subtle little shift by Perkovic to his right as that ball was transitioning. And then look at the plant rotate through, and that thing absolutely paints the corner. Nobody on the planet is making that stop.
So now, and now Acello coming around on the curl. They go back to Perkovic, and he has two in a row. So he's cooking it up right now for the Irish. But will they have enough time?
When this team goes on a run, it's on the back of 50 and White, Matt Kavanaugh, and this guy right here, Sergio Perkovic. The big righty shooter out of the state of Michigan wills his team and is relentless in the fourth quarter. Wants the ball on his stick, Q.
Perkovic is right here on the right, freeze it. And you see the defense just shade. This is Reese, who's just staring at the ball carrier. He loses all perspective of where Perkovic is right here. And now you let it roll. Goes for the pickoff there. A better approach would be to back off and then find that right-handed shooter. Right.
Perkovic back to his left, and somehow that goes in. The bounce shot makes it a three-goal game with 3:38 left to play. You wanted tempo? You have tempo.
Perkovic trying to take this game over with the last three Notre Dame goals. Recruited by Northwestern to play football. 6'4", brilliant student, and a powerful shooter. Just won't be denied. There's nothing fancy here. He leans in, spins back towards his weak left hand, and lets it rip.
Q, that's the only spot that ball would have fallen on the plant. He had a wide base. He covered the left side with his
strong. Notre Dame still with a big hill to climb. Perkovic for 2 points, maybe. Oh, my! Four in the fourth for Sergio Perkovic.
Can someone tell Denver that 16 in White is lethal from the outside? Some guys just want the ball in pressure moments. We saw it as a freshman when he had 5 goals against Duke in the national title game. He wants to single-handedly take this game over, and there is no range limits when you shoot overhand 102 miles an hour, old school. It cashes in.
Can we burn the tapes when I said Sergio Perkovic's been quiet? Now they send PJ Finley out to the X. Again, anticipate the Now Perkovic. Gets a pick from Acello. Gets picked up by the shorty. Jump shot anyway! Oh, my! We are witnessing one of the greatest individual performances in this championship's history. And it's taken less than a quarter. They're staying in the 10-man ride. And they are back in this game because of one Sergio Perkovic.
The ball screen changes the matchup. Reese is in fine shape until he gets picked off, and then you see the size and the strength differential. But that's an unbelievable shot. LaPlante's a lefty. This is offside hip. It's on the run, fadeaway jump shot to the ideal spot. Five straight, Sergio.
When he was a freshman, a friend of Kevin Corrigan's watched him at practice, and Kevin turned to the friend and said, he might be the best
catch
guy we've
play.
Ever had.
Catch and play.
Big sophomore. Quiet first three quarters. Has caught fire.
I woke up in the night.
Up with smoke. Pays a corner.
I woke
the confidence
up in
soaring with every touch.
Door.
Leans in, uses his body. You see the range from outside 15. Yeah, I can do it on the run too. I'm a complete midfielder. And I'm carrying the team on my back.
Look at that wrist.
On the run.